Welcome to Crawdaddy's Custom Crankbaits. Tonight I'm just going to play around with this new bait or new blank I got. My son is wanting a dark or red color crawfish, so I'm going to play around with this H2O blood red candy and see what we can come up with. I went ahead and primed it white, put a pearl silver over it, and then I applied my netting to get my veining look. And I'm afraid I've already scratched the paint on it, but if I did, I'd just come back and touch it up. I'm just gonna come over the top of the back and put in some of this candy red. And this stuff is pretty dark, so you really have to be careful on how dark you really go with it. But all I'm doing is just coming across the back. Let it fade down the sides. I'll have to more likely repaint the bottom anyway, so I'm really not worried about overspray. This is going to be a dark bait. Need my airbrush. I'm going to take some black ink. Normally when I do this, leaving the white for the lines, I've already go ahead and paint my shell marking, so I hope I didn't screw up by not doing that. I'm gonna take some black ink and just lightly darken just the back a little bit. Thank you. bit come down the sides. I want to heat set this real quick. Take off my clamps and hope for the best. Yeah, I scratched the white all up. I thought I did. I should have let that primer dry a little bit more. I'm gonna go ahead and clean my airbrush out. But that is the gamble you take when you're using the netting or anytime you're using those clamps, that you're taking the gamble that you're scratching and going to scratch your paint off. But that's what happens, and that's part of painting. But anyway, while I'm cleaning my airbrush, I want to make sure I get it clean. I want to take this time to thank everyone for subscribing to my channel and supporting me. I really appreciate it. I'm gonna take some white and try to touch all this up. The thing is, when you're painting and you screw up, don't get upset or aggravated. Just try to come back and fix the mistakes. And I can tell you, it's going to happen. Clean this out real quick. I don't know about everybody else, but I really think white is one of the hardest things to get out of your airbrush. Gonna put like a drop of pearl silver. Take some black ink. I was going to try a reverse crawl pattern on this. I think I'm still gonna try it. getting dark around my eyes. Not 100% sure what color I'm gonna do the bottom. Oh, that stupid air compressor. But I'm gonna take the bigger dots and come in here and put my markings. Think I'm gonna come in here with some small ones. Turn this over and hope like the dickens I can see where to put them go across the back. Airbrush out real quick. I hope this is not too dark. We're gonna find out. This is grabber orange candy. Oh, spit water. Dry that off real quick. Nice one, nice. Don't know why I'm painting. Oh, come on, water. Just probably let that orange up into the red. Well, it's just not going to quit spitting on me. You can have a filter system on it, and sometimes, no matter what you do, you wanted something different. Red and orange bottom. That is definitely different. Go ahead and pull the tape off. But once I clear this thing, it's really going to pop. To go back over what I used is I use blood red, I believe it's called. Yeah, blood red candy. And the orange is grabber orange. They're both H2O candies. But I put a white base coat down. Then I came back over it with pearl silver. Put my netting on it to get these crackling effect or veining effect. But anyway, once you dip this thing, I think it's really going to pop. And I think he's going to be happy with it. But anyway, that's what I had tonight from Crawdaddy's. Like I said, I want to thank everyone who's subscribed to my YouTube channel and supporting me. Means a lot. If I can help anybody, just PM me on my Facebook page, or I'll be more than glad to help anyone. So, But that's what Crawdaddy said for you tonight, and thanks for watching, and until next time, we'll see you then.